Hello everyone, this is Alejandro Cremades, and today we're going to be talking about how to determine the amount to raise in your financing round. So coming up with the amount that you're going to be raising in your financing round, whether it's a seed, series A, series B, or whatever that is really an art. But there is different methods that you can actually use to really come up with that amount. So with that being said, let's get into it. So first is the key figures that you need to know. So on the first hand, you know, like what you're going to see is really the monthly burn that you have. You need to understand how much cash are you burning every month, meaning how much you're in the red every month that you're operating. And for the most part, if you're at an early stage, you're going to be talking about staff and potential, you know, also the rent. Those are the two biggest expenses that you're gonna have. And then you can add in there the software that you're using and any other type of subscriptions that are adding up every month to your monthly bill. So that is the monthly burn, and that is a number that you need to really have a clear grasp on. The other figure that you really wanna keep in mind is the cost of getting to your next milestone. And that is without counting with your existing revenues, only counting with your monthly burn. How many months or how much is it going to cost you? If maybe like your next milestone is in 12 months or in 18 months or in 24 months, how much money is that without counting with revenues? That is a critical figure that you need to know. Then you have the key strategic considerations. So obviously on the first hand, it's gonna be all about dilution. You know, how much equity are you gonna be giving away? The rule of thumb in every financing round is that you are not diluting the equity ownership by more than 20 or 25%. You want to always keep it under those figures so that you are not over diluting yourself and you can continue to mature the business. Because remember that if you're really building and executing a hyper growth business, you're gonna probably have to go through different financing cycles. And on every financing cycle, you're going to experience some type of dilution. So with that being said, you really need to have a clear understanding of what the dilution is going to be, what is going to be the potential valuation of the business for that amount that you're raising, and so forth, no? The other thing is the control and the flexibility. Obviously, the more dilution, the less control that you and your co-founders are gonna have. And for that reason, you wanna make sure that also you're thinking about the potential player that is going to come in, or that profile of investor that is going to come in, and that perhaps is going to share control, vote, and voice with you at a board level with the business. Then you wanna think about investment levels. You know, there's great people out there, such as, for example, Chris Dixon from Marc Andreessen, that he says that whatever you want to raise, you want to add on top of that 50% more just as a buffer. Now, you're going to have different scenarios. You're going to have the ideal scenario where, you know, like everything is falling into place. You're getting, you know, the exact amount that you need to execute. You're going to have the worst case scenario, which you need to prepare for, where essentially you're not raising enough to maybe like reach your milestones in 18 to 24 months. Maybe you're just raising for like 12 months and that's okay, but you're gonna have to really figure out how you're gonna go out to market right away. And then you're gonna have probably the realistic, you know, scenarios, which is more on the conservative side. Maybe you're gonna shoot, you know, a little bit lower instead of going for the 24 months. Maybe you just go for the 12 right away. But again, you know, you're gonna have different scenarios and you need to be able to walk the investor through what you're capable of doing. For example, like if you give me $5 million, I can do, you know, between this and that. If you give me $10 million, I can do a little bit more, you know, and accelerate by this and that. So basically what you're showcasing to the investor is that by raising more money, you can still deploy in a very good way, in a very productive way, that money. But in essence, what you're doing is accelerating even farther whatever you were set out to accomplish. So in some instances, you might see the investor that you're asking him for five to accomplish X or to accomplish Y, and they give you double because they want to go double, you know, a little bit more faster on the execution side, no? In the end, remember that there's going to be two types of valuations. You're going to have the founder valuation, which is what you think that the business is worth, and then you're going to have the market valuation, which is, at the end of the day, what the market is paying you. Now, at the end of the day, when it comes, you know, down to real, to really putting that valuation in place and to determining the amount that you're raising, you need to keep in mind the following things. How much money you need to achieve for your goals. The type of investor, whether it's an angel, a VC, a family and friends, etc. Your prior success as an entrepreneur. The going rate for similar companies. The growth rate of related sectors and marketplaces. How likely is that your startup will reach profitability? The level of revenue currently or potentially generated by the business. The team that you have around you. Customer acquisition and distribution of your company. Lastly, you want to make sure that you have a financial forecast that is really not only guiding you to really understand what potentially that's going to be in terms of the amount to raise, but also that you can present to the investor. The forecast is really where you're putting all those monthly expenses, you know, whatever it's going to cost you, whatever hires that you're planning to make, you know, whatever revenue that you're expecting, like projected income expenses. All of that, you're going to be putting it all in 3 to 5 years. I mean, it depends on the investor that you're going to be seeing. You know, some may want to see 3 years of forecast. Others may want to see 5 years of forecast. But essentially, what you're doing with the financial forecast is going to be the following. Show the financial viability of your startup. Identify potential risks. Provide a clear understanding of future financial needs. Allow future comparisons between forecast and business operations. Show financial responsibility on your part. So hopefully this provided some guidance as you're thinking about like determining the amount that you raise in your round. Again, there's also some nice benchmarks, you know, for SaaS companies, such as the ones that we provide, you know, like on our platform on the fundraising training. And again, you know, like if you like this video, make sure that you hit the like button, make sure that you comment and that you also subscribe so that you don't miss out on any of the future videos that we're going to be launching. And going back to the fundraising training, where you're going to be able to see all these frameworks and how to raise money, what valuation and so forth. There we have essentially live trainings, agreements, templates, hundreds of founders all over the world helping each other. And essentially it's a program where we help founders every step of the way in the fundraising journey from A all the way to C. So hopefully you like this video. Thank you.